Let's take a look at the starting project file for this video series, so you are more comfortable with the HTML and CSS that's already in place. Here is our starting practice file opened up in Firefox, and we also have the Firebug plugin open. We will use the Firebug just to get a quick familiarity with the actual HTML that we have set up. So first, let's take a look at that. Down here in the HTML panel, you can see it's a very simple structure. We have an HTML5 header tag. We have a section tag, both siblings of each other. The header tag has an H1 tag in it, and the section tag has an H2 tag and two P tags in it. So there isn't too much to that. If we use Firebug, we can actually highlight over these, and you can see them up here in the browser window as they're being selected. And we can also see the layout over on the right-hand side. And if you look at the layout panel, you'll notice that each of the tag elements that are in our document are set up for a position property of static. So that means they just flow one after another down the page, as you might expect in a normal flow layout. The CSS is at the document level, so we can take that tag and open it up. There's the style tag with the CSS. Or we can view it over here in the CSS panel for Firebug. There's nothing too surprising in the CSS for this document. We'll notice that first the header and section elements are being set so they're recognized for legacy browsers. Then we're using the universal selector to set color, margin, and padding for all the other elements. The body has a background and a family for the fonts. The header section we're targeting inside the header element, the H1, for its properties such as background, font size, height, padding, and line width. And then the other major part of the document is the section element, and it has internally an H2 and a P tag, and we are also targeting those. These are our base CSS selectors, styles, and properties, and they will apply into all different types of views, including a iPhone view or a Samsung Galaxy view or an iPad or any tablet view, or even as you see them right here on our web browser, which is a rather wide width web browser in a very large monitor. So what we'll do is we'll modify these properties and selectors based on detecting the width of the screen using CSS media queries. And we'll do that so that our view looks more appropriate for that particular width. But first, we will start by understanding how the default mobile device width and scaling is controlled. You may have noticed web pages on your smartphone too tiny to read and requiring horizontal scrolling to view them. We can then start detecting device widths using CSS media queries.